Hello and welcome to my channel, The Lab Rats. Today's topic is pepain, pepsin, and beta mercaptoethanol treatment of antibody. And these three experiments actually helped in discovery of antibody structure. Nowadays, both direct theoretical and experimental questions are asked from this topic in almost every examination. So basically, this topic is very important. Also, those who want to learn about the basics of antibodies, such as antibody structure, classification of antibody, they can find the link for those videos in the description box. Also, the link of those videos are right now flashing on the upper right corner of this video. Now, let's begin with today's topic. In 1972, Gerald M. Edelman and Rodney R. Porter received Nobel Prize in Physiology and Medicine for the discovery of antibody structure. There are three major scientists behind the discovery of antibody structure, and they are Gerald M. Edelman, Rodney R. Porter, and Alfred Nissenoff. They did their experiment independently, but later on all their findings were combined to find the final structure of antibody that we know today. Their experiments can be categorized into two different groups, that is proteolytic and chemical treatment of immunoglobulin. During proteolytic treatment, they used enzymes, and the name of those enzymes were pepain and pepsin. During chemical treatment, they used a reducing agent, and the name of that reducing agent is beta mercaptoethanol, and we also call it BME. Treatment of IgG by pepain enzyme by Rodney R. Porter. So in his experiment, Rodney R. Porter used rabbit IgG and digested it with the help of enzyme pepain. The source of pepain enzyme is papaya. It is present in papaya latex. Pepain is a non-specific enzyme. Thiol endopeptidase. So here thiol, it indicates the presence of thiol group in the active site of this enzyme. This thiol group is very important for the activity of pepain enzyme. So whenever we use pepain for any experiment, we use a reducing agent along with it. So to keep this thiol group in reduced form and maintain the activity of pepain enzyme. According to this experiment, when we treat antibody, by antibody we mean to say IgG, immunoglobulin G. So when we treat IgG with pepain enzyme, it generates three fragments of the antibody, total three fragments. Out of these three fragments, two fragments are identical and they are different in different immunoglobulin. That is, they show different sequences, different property in different classes of immunoglobulin. Also, this fragment was showing antigen binding property, that is, it could interact with the antigen. Rodney R. Porter named this fragment as FAB fragment. FAB stands for antigen binding fragment. The third fragment was different than the other two fragments. It was similar in all the immunoglobulin. It did not have any antigen binding property, but it had an additional property which was crystallizable. It was crystallizable at low temperature. So Rodney R. Porter named this fragment as FC fragment. FC stands for crystallizable fragment. The molecular weight of FAB fragment was approximately 45 kDa. And that of FC fragment was 50 kDa. This is a basic structure of immunoglobulin. Immunoglobulin has two heavy chains and two light chains. Okay, two light chains and two heavy chains. There are disulfide bond in between the two heavy chains and also between the heavy chain and light chains. In the heavy chain of immunoglobulin, there is a flexible amino acid sequence which is known as hinge region. This is present between CH2 and CH3 domain. Okay, so it is present between the second and third constant domain of heavy chain. You can find about this in detail in my previous videos. The cleavage site for pepain is somewhere above the disulfide bond, which is present in the hinge region. Okay, so pepain cuts above the disulfide bond, which is present in the hinge region. And basically, there are three fragments that are generated. So this is a lower fragment, which has the portion of heavy chain, both the heavy chain. And it also has some of the region of hinge region, which is comprising the disulfide bonds. Apart from this, there are two these fragments, the above fragments, which has half of the portion of heavy chain and the complete light chain, and they are joined by the disulfide bonds. So basically, when we treat IgG by pepain enzyme, it generates three fragments. Out of these three fragments, these two FAB fragments are identical. And they are known as FAB fragments because they can bind to the antigen, because the paratopic region of immunoglobulins are intact in these fragments. Now the other is the FC fragment, which has portions of only heavy chain, and these are joined by the disulfide bond, which is present in this fragment. Now we know that the molecular weight of immunoglobulin G is approximately 150 kDa. Okay, the heavy chains of IgG are approximately 50 kDa molecular weight, and light chains have approximately 25 kilodalton of molecular weight. So if you see here, the papain enzyme cuts this heavy chain almost in the middle. So half of the both heavy chain joins together to form approximately a 50 kilodalton fragment. So overall, if you treat immunoglobulin G with papain enzyme, so it will form two FAB fragment and one FC fragment. Treatment of IgG by pepsin enzyme by Alfred Nesenoff. Alfred Nesenoff in his experiment used IgG and treated it with pepsin enzyme. Pepsin enzyme is found in stomach. Now this pepsin is also non-specific endopeptidase. According to this experiment, when we treat antibody, again by antibody we mean to say IgG. So when we treat antibody with pepsin enzyme, it generates one large fragment and multiple small fragments. Okay. The larger fragment has two FAB regions. Okay. So basically in case of papain, both these FAB regions are separated in two different fragments. But here the single largest fragment has both of the FAB regions. Due to this, we can call this largest fragment bivalent, and the name of this fragment was FAB prime 2. So now let's understand the meaning of this term. FAB stands for antigen binding fragment. So of course, even the both FAB regions were joined together in a single fragment, they were retaining their antigen interaction property. They could interact with the antigen, bind to the antigen. So this fragment was named as FAB, antigen binding fragment. Now AB hold 2, that is antigen binding hold 2, is indicating that single fragment has two antigen binding surfaces, two antigen binding sites. So this is hold 2. Now with the prime, this symbol represents some additional sequences apart from the FAB region. Okay, some of the additional sequences that are present in this fragment, and they are represented by this prime symbol. The molecular weight of this FAB prime 2 fragment was approximately 100 kilodalton. Apart from this largest fragment, there are various multiple fragments of the FC region. So multiple FC subfragments are generated. Now in case of pepsin, its digestion site is below the hinge region. Okay, so this time this lower fragment does not contain the disulfide bond of the hinge region. Okay, so both these strands will be separated. If you see the above fragment, so here this is one FAB fragment, this is second FAB fragment, but this time they are joined by this disulfide bond because this hinge region is included in the upper fragment. So when we digest IgG with pepsin enzyme, it generates a larger fragment which is known as FAB prime 2, FAB antigen binding fragment, because these two antigen binding sites are intact here. They can bind to, they can interact to the antigens. Prime symbol because of the presence of this additional hinge region sequence. Apart from that, there are several FC subfragments that are generated in this digestion process. So overall, if you treat an immunoglobulin G with pepsin enzyme, so there will be one FAB prime 2 fragment. Okay, and there will be multiple FC subfragments. Now we already discussed that this FC fragment will be approximately 50 kilodalton, less than more than, some of the differences will be there, but it will be around to 50 kilodalton molecular weight, and the overall molecular weight of IgG is 150. So if you subtract this FC subfragment molecular weight, that is 50, so you will get approximately 100 kilodalton for this FAB prime 2 fragment, which was Alfred Nesenoff getting in his experiment. Treatment of IgG by beta-mercaptoethanol by Gerald M. Edelman. So So Gerald M. Edelman in his experiment used IgG and digested it with the help of beta mercaptoethanol. Beta mercaptoethanol is a reducing agent. Okay, so according to his experiment, when we treat IgG by beta mercaptoethanol, so overall four fragments are generated. We can divide these four fragments into two subpopulation. One is two identical smaller fragment and two identical larger fragment. So because the smaller fragment had low molecular weight, it was known as light chain, and larger fragment had high molecular weight, it was known as heavy chain. Okay, now let's understand about the mechanism of action of beta mercaptoethanol. Beta mercaptoethanol is a reducing agent. What about immunoglobulin? Immunoglobulins are protein. Proteins are made up of polypeptide chain, and these polypeptide chain are made up of various amino acids which are joined by the peptide bond. Now one of the amino acid is cysteine. Cysteine is a sulfur containing amino acid, and it contains thiol group. This thiol group is also known as sulfhydryl group, and it is represented as this. Okay, so this thiol group present in cysteine residue helps in formation of disulfide bond. Now suppose these are two polypeptides, and these are the various amino acids which are present in these polypeptides. Now let's suppose these two are the cysteine residues. So there will be thiol group in both the cysteine residues. Under oxidizing condition, these two hydrogens are released. And a disulfide bond is generated between these two thiol groups. There will be a disulfide bond. So this is a kind of interchain disulfide bond. So now what is the function of beta mercaptoethanol? So BME will again reduce these two thiol groups. Okay, it will reduce these two thiol groups and break the disulfide bond between them. So these thiol groups are reduced and the disulfide bond is broken. So this is how BME acts. If you see in an immunoglobulin, there are interchain disulfide bond between both the heavy chains. Then there are interchain disulfide bond between heavy and light chain also. Okay, even if in those immunoglobulin where hinge region is not present, In those immunoglobulin also the disulfide bond is present between the heavy chains. Okay, you can learn about them in detail in my previous videos. So when this immunoglobulin is treated with beta mercaptoethanol, it breaks all these disulfide bonds, interchain disulfide bond, and separate all these four chains. Okay, so it generates two heavy chains and two light chains. So now we can represent all these thiol group in this way, like these are reduced now. Now this disulfide bond between the heavy and light chain are also reduced. So we can represent them like this. It's just for representation. You do not need to remember all these disulfide bond position. Okay. So this is how this whole immunoglobulin will be separated into four chains, two heavy and two light chain. So during his experiment, Gerald M. Edelman found that the heavier chain were approximately 50 kDa each, and lighter chain were approximately 25 kDa each. So all these experiments were done by three different group of scientists in entirely different corners of the world. But their independent results were not strong enough to find the structure of antibody. Also, there were so many questions that were needed to be answered. For example, which chain interacts with the antigen? Also, which portion of the immunoglobulin crystallizes? So to answer all these questions and to deduce the structure of antibody, all the results were combined and a final experiment was done. So during this experiment, scientists took rabbit IgG, rabbit immunoglobulin G, and they split the IgG into FAB and FC fragment. So suppose this is goat 1 and this is goat 2. So one of the fragment was injected in goat 1 and other fragment was injected in goat 2, and these two goats were immunized. Because these two fragments were antigen or like a foreign molecule for these goats, they started producing antibodies against these fragments. So in case of goat 1, what kind of antibody would have formed? एंटी एफ ए बी एंटीबॉडी. इट विल फॉर्म एंटीबॉडी अगेंस्ट दी एफ ए बी फ्रेगमेंट एंड गोट टू विल फॉर्म एंटीबॉडी अगेंस्ट दी एफ सी फ्रेगमेंट. So what they did next is that they interacted both these antibodies with all kind of fragments that were generated during those three experiments. So they found that in case of anti-FAB antibody, it was reacting with both the light and heavy chain. So because the antibody against the FAB fragment was reacting with both the light and heavy chain, it was clear that the FAB fragment contains both the light and heavy chain. In case of anti-FC antibody, it was interacting only with the heavy chain. So as the antibody against FC fragment was interacting only with the heavy chain, it was clear that the FC region contains only heavy chain. So now if you try to combine all the results, so in case of BME, it was found that immunoglobulin has two larger heavy chains and it has two smaller light chains. From the immunization reaction, it was found that in case of FAB region, both light chain and heavy chain are present, and in FC region, only heavy chains are present. So it was concluded that some of the portion of heavy chain must be interacting with the light chain to form the FAB region, and the rest of its portion must be forming FC region where no light chain interaction was shown. In case of papain, it was found that in an immunoglobulin, there are two FAB region, there are two antigen binding fragment and one FC fragment, and that both these FAB regions, that is both these antigen binding regions, are present at the same end of the immunoglobulin, which was shown in case of pepsin. Okay, so we can say that some of the portion of heavy chain must be interacting with the light chain, which are forming the FAB fragments. During pepsinization, it was found that below the FAB regions, there are some special sequences. And now we know that these sequences are the hinge region. Okay. So now the molecular weight of these FAB fragments are approximately 45 kDa. So now the rest of the portion of heavy chain must be present in this side after the hinge region to constitute the approximately 50 kDa molecular weight of the FC fragment. Also, the BME digestion showed that there are disulfide bonds between the heavy chains and there are disulfide bonds between the heavy and light chains also. So this is how the structure of antibody was deduced for the first time by these three major experiments and by the help of these three wonderful scientists. Thank you so much for watching the video. If this video was useful to you, please like and share it, subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell icon for recent updates. You can post all your video related queries in the comment section. Also, for your video related queries and recent update, you can follow us on Facebook and Instagram. The link for those pages are in the description box. So see you in the next video. Until then, keep learning and keep motivating.